Okay guys, so I had this whole plan to like, you know, try and do like the YouTubers do and film me doing like my wash routine in the shower. But the way this bathroom is set up and the lighting in my shower, I just was like, no, I'm sorry, I can't do it. So I'm just gonna show you guys the products that I use. So put you guys here. We just came back from our walk, so the hair is dirty. So I showed you guys in my, I think it was my Instagram stories. I showed you guys like what I used, but I'm gonna bring all the products together. I'm so awkward. Okay, so let's see. You guys are probably gonna think I'm crazy because I use like more than one like shampoo. So we have my Pattern Beauty Clarifying Shampoo, and then we have my Shimmer Light Blonde and Silver Shampoo, because I am, you know, my hair is bleached, it's blonde. And then I'm going to use, actually, I'm going to bring you guys over here because it's still wet. So I have this As I Am Olive and Tea Tree Oil Conditioner. I do this for my scalp. I have not seen dandruff on my scalp like in a while, so I would say this is pretty freaking good. And then actually, let me switch you guys around. I started using this Hawaiian Silky Hair Yogurt Intensive Treatment. It's so good. It smells so good. It's really, really good. I like it. I use it all the time, honestly. Can I turn this around? Oh, and then this is to massage my scalp. That's, I feel like that's why my hair is pretty growing. Cause, oh God, it won't stay. That's why my hair has been growing, because, you know, you gotta stimulate your scalp and stuff like that. So yeah, there's that. This is my protein treatment. So it's Manuka honey and yogurt. I absolutely love Manuka honey. Why am I so out of breath right now? I have the Hydrate and Repair Protein Power Treatment. I think you have to put this on for about 3 minutes, maybe. Oh no, you leave on for 10 to 15. I will be doing this today, but I probably won't leave it on for that long. I most likely won't leave it on for that long. So yeah, so that is what I use. And then over here we have my pride and joy, the Aussie 3-Minute Miracle Moist Deep Conditioner. This big bottle, it's pretty big in my opinion, was $5 at Target. So that is what I use. And yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and wash this. It's really not that bad. I wash my hair every week. Again, simply because like I do have to like get the product out and stuff like that. And I think that my hair looks dry right now, obviously, because it's been a week, but she's pretty good. She's pretty good. I've been actually taking pretty freaking good care of her. Surprisingly, I honestly thought I wouldn't have been so good at it, but we're doing it, so I'm kind of excited. I've tried to film hair videos like in the past, and I just gave up. So this is gonna be my first one, and I'm excited to show you guys me doing a twist out. So okay, since I feel like no one ever really gets to see my hair wet, this is what it looks like. So I forgot to tell you guys, I am a lazy natural, okay? So I just piled on the protein treatment, the hair intensive treatment, and my dandruff conditioner all at the same time. So that way it can really, really get into the hair follicle, and then I can put this on, which is a heated gel cap that I microwaved for 1 minute. So that way when I'm washing off my body and stuff like that, whenever I wash my hair, I wash my body essentially twice, because you know, you gotta wash off the conditioner after everything. So yeah, so I'm gonna do this for about, I mean, it usually takes me like
feel like 3 minutes. So this is gonna stay on for like 3 minutes, 3 to 5 minutes. It just really depends. Also, I don't know if you guys can tell, my hair is definitely getting more like blush pink and I'm feeling it. So I kind of want to do lavender next, but that's not what this video is about right now. So yeah, so I'm gonna put that on, finish showering, and I will see you guys when I am putting all my stuff in my hair. Okay guys, so now comes the time where it's time to do our hair. I was gonna use the Pattern Beauty products again, like the styling cream and the curl gel. I might still use the styling cream, we'll just see, but I wanted to show you guys that today I'm probably just gonna actually go with my oils and then As I Am and the TGIN. Well, these two leave-in conditioners are non-negotiables, they have to go in my hair. But the curling jelly, the oil treatment that I just put on my scalp, and then I'm gonna try this detangling conditioner today. Just bought it. I'm gonna see how my twist out turns out like that. Obviously, I know these work, but the one that I did last week with the Pattern Beauty, was just a little too tight for my liking personally, so I kind of want more of a relaxed, you know, twist out. But you guys are still gonna get great tips, don't worry. This is obviously simply for parting my hair. I use this actually to brush out my curls, and my mom just got me this, so I'm still kind of getting used to it. It kind of sucks, but I feel like it's for girls with looser curl textures, but I'm gonna try it since I have this. You need your clips, obviously, and then just some hair ties. I have some more. I usually use scrunchies, but I use those just to part my hair. And then, because it's kind of spilling right now, I have my jojoba oil. Let's go over here. I have my jojoba oil, obviously, and then my Jamaican black castor oil. So, yep, that is what we will be doing. I'm gonna show you guys how I use all of these. All right, now that all that cringiness is over, let's get into this tutorial. So I have my hair wrapped up in a microfiber towel. That is definitely way better than using a t-shirt, in my opinion. I'll probably never go back. I start with a water-based leave-in conditioner. I love the As I Am leave-in conditioner. It is honestly like the best conditioner leave-in conditioner I've ever used, like ever. Also, pay no mind to literally me jamming to the This Is Justin Bieber playlist on Spotify. Quite embarrassing, but you know, sometimes you just gotta do a little throwback, you know what I'm saying? So I do that, or I put the leave-in conditioner all throughout my hair because, like I said, it's water-based, so it is absolutely the best like base conditioner, leave-in conditioner, whatever, to use on your hair, especially when you have hair like mine that's bleached and it's 4C. It needs all the moisture it can literally get. So now I have my hair parted in 4 sections because I like my hair to be split down the middle, and you guys will see why later. This was actually my first time using that As I Am detangling conditioner because I literally just bought it the day before, and then I was like, ooh, I can use it in this video. And that was me being shocked by the next song that came up. I was so shook by that playlist. It's really good, check it out, please. Please check it out. Anyways, so I put that all on that one section, put all my faith in it, and then I just went in with the wide tooth comb. Wide tooth comb is my best friend. I have also broken many wide tooth combs. So life's a little hard out here for girls like me, okay? But I just use the wide tooth comb, and if you have a problem with the way I detangle my hair, honestly, just click off now. just click off now because I'm a little rough with my hair, but she's strong. She's a strong girl. She's great. She's good. I just part it any old kind of way so I can just, you know, get through it. And all right, so next we're going in with the TGIN green tea super moist leave-in conditioner. Wow, what a mouthful. So I take the top off of that because she's a little thick to go through whatever you want to call that thing. So I just put it all over my hand and I just really, really saturate my hair in it. Pay mind to it now that I left out a piece of my hair in the back, so it's not getting as much love as these other strands, and that kind of upsets me as I watch this back. Again, really feeling this playlist, really feeling it. I love it. Really, seriously, check it out. So now I am using jojoba oil. Jojoba oil is great for sealing in moisture, because again, my hair really needs it. To my 4C girls, seriously, you need jojoba oil in your life. It's gonna change your life. Like, it's great. And then I use Jamaican black castor oil on top of that, pretty much for my edges. As you can see now, I remembered that piece of hair back there, or I found it, I should say. So only really got some oil on it. Sad day. Here I'm using an olive and tea tree oil treatment for my scalp because I have had dandruff my whole life. And then when I found this, it honestly feels like it just didn't exist anymore. So now we're really, really getting into it. I am starting off with the As I Am curling jelly. To keep up appearances, I am using a rat tail comb. Normally I would just part it, however, I'm not usually this formal. So you guys are seeing a formal side of me, you know what I'm saying? So I take the curling jelly and I just saturate my section, I guess you can call it, in it. And then I use the Pattern Beauty. They call it a shower brush because you're really supposed to use it in the shower, but I use it when I am doing any of my hairstyles at all. It gives you that really, really defined curl look, as you can see, and that is just perfect for me beginning my twist out. So I am doing the twist right now. It's a two-strand twist. I know it's really fast right now, but do not worry. I am absolutely going to slow it down so you guys can really see how I did that, because I mean, that was super fast. So let's get into it. I am sorry, y'all. I am really struggling with this voiceover. I have not done a voiceover in so long. Okay, so you obviously see that I parted my hair again. You really, really want to get a lot, as much as possible, of the curling jelly on your hands. Saturate the hair. I'm trying to use this tangle teaser thing that my mom got me, and yeah, it's not for me. I started to kind of believe it, maybe a little bit, but no, I'm just gonna stick to my Pattern Beauty brush. It gives me, you know, total control, and that's just what I'm gonna use. Like, look at them curls. Are you kidding me? That's something that Tangle Teaser is not gonna help me with. So here it is, slowed down. I split, you know, my hair into two, and you just basically overlap it. How I would best describe it is, it's like when you close the braid back up with the little twist tie. You just act like you're twist tying something or whatever, and that is how you're gonna get a twist. That is how you're gonna get a two strand twist. And you know, you can also, what most people do, which I don't do because I'm lazy, but what most people do is, you see the part as I'm going down, like how it is, that can easily get tangled. So what most people do is, you know, comb at it or brush it while they're twisting. And I don't know if you guys can see kind of sort of in the middle there, there's some curls like sticking out. It would be a lot easier and a lot better for your twist to be seamless. If you do that, I don't do that, but it definitely would make the twists look a lot better when they come out, and it'll give you less tangles. So now I'm at the end and I just finger coil it and then I let it go. And yeah, I just, I love this part in specifically because I wanted to show you guys how I kind of get that bang effect. A lot of people ask me how I make it look like I have bangs. I literally just take the like section in front of me and the section at the front, so that's what at my crown, right, basically, and I just do what I did to the other twist, but I twist them forward as opposed to backwards, because if you want that bang effect, if you want it to not look so much like an afro, you kind of want it to go like, how do you explain it, like down instead of out. That is definitely the secret to how that's gonna look. I'm just so obsessed with my curls. Like, look at how good they look. Like, people cannot believe that my hair or that my curls still look that good after bleaching it. I can't believe it either. I thought I was gonna be bald, but here we are. I still have hair. We love to see it. So yeah, I basically just do the same thing that I did, and it just turns out, you know, it turns out different every time, but it's always a bang. There's always that little bang effect that goes on, so I can't really complain. I just want to give you guys a little bit of an update. This is the, you know, section that you guys saw me do, and then this is the back. So yeah, curls are super juicy, they're super hydrated, and that's exactly what we want. So yeah, I love it. I just love how they look, like, especially with the pink. It's just, oh, it's so amazing. So yeah, so then next time you guys will see me is when I'm taking them out. So I don't, I do leave them in for 2 days sometimes. It just really depends on what my schedule is like. But tomorrow I want to take them out so I can show you guys, because I won't have time to do it Monday morning when I work. And that was another thing I wanted to mention, something. Oh, so this curling jelly that I use, it says on the side it's actually designed for wash and go styling. I just wanted to make you guys kind of aware of that. I personally don't like the way my wash and goes look, number one. Number two, like, when I use that curling jelly, do my curls look defined? Yes, but I don't know. I like, this is like why I spend the time to do twist outs, because I like the volume. I like how my hair looks that way. When I just do a wash and go, I feel like I look like little orphan Annie. I'm not into it. So yeah. So next time you guys see me, it will be when I'm taking the twist out. All right, so I put jojoba oil all over my hands, because if you undo a twist out without any oil on your hands, you're gonna get a frizzy looking mess, and that's not cute. That's not what we want. So I also did not do a great job of showing you guys me twisting it out because I was in a rush that morning. And then also, remember I told you guys a little bit earlier that, you know, it'd be a lot better if you combed as you twisted. Yeah, I definitely need to incorporate that into my routine, because I was definitely running into some tangles while I was undoing my twist. So yeah, this is how I undo my twist. Okay, so you guys, the last clip you saw was me taking my hair out. So this is what the twist out looks like. Sometimes it just wants to part in the middle. It's totally fine. So yeah, this is what it looks like. I didn't show you guys, but I put jojoba oil all over my hands, and then just twisted it out and then plucked it a little in my butt. So we love it. This color is so amazing too. I need to re-dye it though, but we're working on that. So, oh, the mic is picking up.
Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that this helped some other lazy natural like me. And if you want more hair content, let me know.